Yo, what is going on, folks? My name is, of course, Cam Angel, and welcome back, everybody, to another brand new video on the channel, guys. Today, a brand new Minecraft bug fix update has just been released for the Minecraft Bedrock Edition called the 1.16.200, or on the PlayStation 4, the TU2.19, with dozens of bug fixes and new highly anticipated features that I'm sure the entire community will be happy to hear about. So, without further ado, let's just jump straight into the news. But, can I just mention, come on, guys, like, look at this. Look at my parkour here. I'm on the Hive today. My God, man, I am looking gorgeous. I am killing this. Nobody kills the high parkour like me, alright? Try me, you know what I'm saying? 1v1, anytime I'll take down anybody, you know what I'm saying? I'm the best at this, I'm telling you. Anyway, let's get right into the actual news though. So, as always, our news does begin on Twitter, and it begins with Jay Wells or Megaspud tweeting out 41 minutes ago saying, "We are releasing Minecraft 1.16.200 today, with new audio volume sliders, render dragon ray tracing features, and a whole load of bug fixes. Check out the changelog at feedback.minecraft.net. Enjoy with a little party emoji." And of course, he obviously shows us some of the new actual volume features and the photo they linked. Now, if we go over to the actual Minecraft feedback website itself, obviously, of course, we do have everything regarding this new Bedrock beta, or not Bedrock beta, this new Bedrock update, sorry. It says Minecraft 1.16.200, and again, not to flex, but look at that parkour. I know, we're going to the next clip, we're going to do some battle. You guys don't have to get jealous, I know I'm that good, alright? But it says Minecraft 1.16.200 Bedrock, posted December 8th, 2020, of course. Or 2020, why did I say 2020? What the frick? 2020. A new update is upon us in the form of the Minecraft 1.16.200. This update is loaded with graphics enchants or enhancements, sorry, Windows 10, updated volume settings, priority changes, and a swath of bug fixes. Please report any bugs you find to bugs.mojang.com and post feedback to feedback.minecraft.net. And then it goes on to the first major thing. Now listen, there is quite a few things here. Like, genuinely, there is quite a good few things. There's a lot of things to cover in this, so, I'll, you know, I do apologize. I'm going to make some mistakes here, there, and everywhere, but just sit back, relax, and just try and take it all in, all right? So, first of all, we've got to talk about the Render Dragon. The Render Dragon, the new graphics engine for Minecraft Bedrock platforms, is now available on Windows 10. Render Dragon was developed by the Mojang Studios graphics team to give our game a greater performance, stability, and flexibility. The new architecture of Render Dragon enables our developers to bring new graphics features, such as physical-based rendering, PBR, and ray tracing more easily to the game. Render Dragon has been available for Xbox and PlayStation hardware since 2019, and we are now bringing it to the Windows 10. We plan to bring Render Dragon to all Minecraft Bedrock platforms, including mobile devices in the future. Minecraft with ray tracing. Enabled ray tracing on Windows 10 with compatible graphics hardware. Players can now dramatically change the look and feel of the game. Immerse yourself in volumetric fog, see Minecraft in a whole new light with a cutting edge dynamic lighting system, ray tracing. Players can also experience advanced kind of block textures, including metallic surfaces, bumps, maps or bump maps, normal maps, light emission, glowy reflective dirt blocks, yes please. Be sure to check out the Frequently Asked Questions article for an in-depth look at ray tracing features. Content in the marketplace is now aware of ray tracing compatibilities and will display a label indicating support within the user interface. Creators, we have some new documentation available for creating content for Minecraft with ray tracing. Texture set documentation, more information on physical based rendering, fog and resource packs, defining fog values within resource packs, all linked down below. Next, we have Minecraft with OpenXR. Minecraft on Windows 10 now uses OpenXR to support Windows MR and Oculus VR. OpenXR is an open source royalty-free API standard that provides engines native access to a wide range of devices from vendors that span across VR/MR devices. OpenXR implementation in Minecraft brings a more unified experience across current VR/MR devices, as well as support for those yet to come. You will still be able to launch through the Mixed Reality Portal as well as the Oculus Store. However, there is also a URL to launch in VR, and obviously gives us the URL itself, and then it says this can be made into a desktop shortcut pinned at the start menu, bookmarked in a browser, or anything else you can do with a URL. Now we've got new features. The new volume settings added a variety of volume sliders for sound effects, e.g. hostile blocks, weather, etc. These play a preview of the prevalent or the relevant, sorry, sounds in the main settings menu and play the default click sound when in game. Vanilla priority changes and fixes. Basalt can no longer be destroyed by gas fireballs. Basalt blocks now take slightly more time to destroy. Dragon egg now always drops as an item when it's destroyed by an explosion. Right clicking a snow block with a shovel no longer breaks the snow block. Dirt paths, formerly grass paths, can now be made using a shovel on dirt, podzoil, mycelium, coarse dirt, and grass. updated netherite leggings texture. Twisting vines can no longer be placed on composter blocks while sneaking. Netherite armor now gives a 90% reduction in knockback. Bees will no longer stray more than 22 blocks from their home beehive. Now we've got known issues. Players running Minecraft on Windows 10 and 32-bit systems may encounter a crash when loading the game if the Media Foundation pack is not installed. This can be resolved by downloading and installing the Media Foundation pack. Players are unable to rejoin a world after being disconnected from a suspended session. In VR, living room hint text doesn't change correspondingly when input method changes from gamepad to motion controller. Moving on, we've got fixes, and to be specific, this is performance and stability fixes. Improved chunk loading speed when flying with Elytra. Large numbers of scheduled instant updates no longer crash the game. Fix a crash that could occasionally occur when going through a portal or flying around in creative mode. Fix a crash that could occasionally occur while flying or moving around the game world. Fixed a crash that could occur when loading a local world. Fixed an issue where some mobile devices would lose audio after suspend and resume. Fixed an issue that caused a crash on Nintendo Switch when trying to load a 256x resolution resource pack. The system now blocks that selection and notifies the player they cannot select it. Now we've got general fixes. Players that own the Founder's Cape will once again see the cape or see it within the Capes tab of the dressing room. Then we've got gameplay fixes. Only preview items will be shown in crafting screen when auto-crafting an item on controller. This prevents rapid updates of the recipe book. Fix the player's hand still bobbing if view bobbing was disabled. Now we've got fixes for mobs. Fix mobs and other entities freezing and becoming desynced with their bodies. Villagers will no longer steal workstations from each other. Mobs no longer randomly stop attacking and following their targets. Piglings that are close together can no longer pick up the same item if it is dropped between them. Update zombify pigling texture to remove flickering of loincloth. Mobs no longer spawn in wither roses. Bees now only exit at the front of the beehive and bee nest. Mobs are no longer teleported back and forth outside solid objects if there is not enough space for multiple entities. Now we've got block fixes. Cocopods generated in jungles now generate in the proper direction. Signs no longer replace directions or decorations while attempting to place in the same space as the decoration. Fixed a bug where end portal blocks were not removed after the end portal frame block was destroyed. Filled blocks other than end portal blocks will remain in place. Now we've got graphical fixes. Owned packs are now refreshed correctly after restarting the game when playing in VR. Now ladies and gentlemen, everything else other than this is all kind of just, I wouldn't say gibberish, but it's all kind of more technical stuff. Now I'm not going to go to the extent of reading out everything so far from here, because honestly guys, I've struggled so far reading everything else that's already been on the screen I've already read. But everything else from here guys, the user interface, I'll fling up all the screenshots on the screen now so you guys can read them. Plus of course the actual link to the Minecraft feedback obviously.net article regarding the 1.16.200 will be linked down below. So if you want to give this all a read for yourself, all this technical kind of mumble jumble, you're more than welcome to, of course. But obviously the user interface stuff, the command stuff, the for maps, for map makers and add-on creators, the fixes, blocks, components, etc. All these things should be on the screen roundabout right now, guys. But that was pretty much everything for this entire update. Now, this was a huge update in general. There is a lot of fixes that I'm very glad to see. A lot of them that I've actually been personally experiencing on my PlayStation 4 Barrel Edition. However, there is some that I've still not actually seen, which is a bit of a worry. But hopefully in the next big update that we get, or the next big bug fix that we get, hopefully we get those resolved and fixed. I gotta be honest, guys, this update as opposed to the 1.16.100 is a little bit, I guess, less, amazing. The 1.16.100, of course, did bring servers and realms to the PlayStation 4 Bedrock Edition, and it also brought over 150 bug fixes to the game. While this one obviously didn't do anything near that, but it still brought some interesting new fixes, and of course some new features, including the new volume settings, which I'm very glad to hear about, because I now fully am playing on Bedrock Edition, and to see this, it is actually a breath of fresh air, guys, so yeah. Anyway, folks, that is the end of today's video. If you did go to enjoy, as always, please be sure to drop a like in it, share it with your friends and family, and of course, be sure to subscribe to help us reach our goal of 50,000 subscribers. A lot of work and effort went into this actual video in general. I had to do a lot of different outtakes and audio takes to try and get the audio perfect so there's no mistakes within it. And obviously, guys, that is quite challenging, to be honest with y'all. It's quite a bit of a pain, especially when I edit everything through my Share Factory. So yeah, please have some sympathy. Please have some care. Please drop a like and please subscribe, guys. Additionally, as well, I may be streaming later on tonight on some servers just to play and enjoy some of the new features from the 1.16.200. So if you haven't already done it, be sure to turn on notifications and come join us later on in tonight's stream and have some fun and chill out and chat with us, and hopefully have a game with us. It'll be pretty fun. But yeah, everybody, thank you for watching today's video. See you guys on the next one. Have a fantastic Tuesday or rest of your Tuesday, and yeah, everybody, peace out.